Hello viewers, assalamu alaikum and good morning to you all. Welcome to my YouTube channel Ishfaq Samoon Vlogs. We will discuss today part B of political science, that is political theory for class 11th. Our topic of discussion is introduction to political theory. So be with me till the end of the lecture. Before discussing political theory in detail, we must know that political theory is a combination of two words, political and theory. So every time when we start to study political science, the first thing we need to know about and understand is political theory. And in order to understand political theory, we have to face many problems. Political theory shapes our thought process towards society from where we belong to. That is why, as a student of political science, we must study, rather we should study political theory, because it helps to explain what is going on around us. It helps to understand our rights and duties. It helps to decide what should be or not should be there. It helps to solve ethical problems. It helps to understand political development and political crisis in the world. So it became necessary to clearly understand the concept of political theory. Once we understand the meaning of political theory and what its functions are, then it will be easy for us to figure out why should we study political theory in detail. Political theory is the combination of two words, as we discussed earlier, political and theory. Let's start first with the theory. What is theory? The first term is a theory that you need to know, otherwise you will not be able to understand anything about political theory. The English word theory comes from the Greek word theoria, which means looking at, viewing, beholding. In a sense of ancient Greek, the theory is to gain knowledge of a particular phenomenon through thoughtfulness and intellectual insight. In general, the theory implies an analytical framework, but proponents of empiricism think that knowledge which is based on some predetermined self-reflection and making a conclusion based on that cannot be called a theory. Further, according to them, theory refers to determining the interrelationship between the various information obtained from the experience and presenting it in a coherent and meaningful way. But the problem is that if the theory is based on only information from experiences, then how do we define the concept of freedom, equality, justice, and so on? So in general, we can say that theory is a systematic study, study for systematic knowledge about a particular phenomena based on abstract ideas, a rational character, generality, and non-speculation in nature. The prime goal of the theory is to find out the human achievable truth. What is political? Now you have to understand what political is. Political mainly refers to power or authority. It also refers to the influence, control, and use of political force or threat. In the newspaper, we see a variety of issues related to rape, racism, gender equality, political party, march against the government. Now, the question is, are these political issues? Yes, these issues are political because of all these issues related to power, and all these are linked to government institutions. So it can be said that political refers to the power to make decisions by the government institutions about common life or society. Here political refers to power with and power to people, power with government institutions and power to common people and society. But is it not 100% true? Raju Bhargav, in his book Political Theory and Introduction, explains it very accurately. He has used an example of women's organization protesting against the exclusion or unequal treatment of women. So far as political has meant that the woman organization has never belonged to the political, because the woman organization is not part of the government organization. But protest by women's groups is political. Their act is political. Women have long struggled against some social practices, unequal treatment over them, means the use of power over them by men or any social practices, exercise of power in any type linked to the political, and it refers to power over also. What is political theory? The main point of this chapter, this lecture, is political theory. We have already got the meaning of theory and political, and now we learn what it meant or what it means when these two words sit together. A British political scientist, David Held, nicely defines political theory as a network of concepts and generalizations about political life involving ideas, assumptions, and statements about the nature, purpose, and key features of government, state, and society, and about the political capabilities of human beings. Further, political theory is a personal endeavor of articulating sections of society in order to transform present imperfect society leading towards perfection. Political theory has been made one of the subfields with the rise of political science as a subject. Political theory is an important and integral part of any society. Political theory is the study of the state from the philosophical and empirical point of view, and a political theory can be referred to as a combination of thoughts, philosophies, and sciences or arts. Political theory deals with the ideas and principles that shape constitutions, governments, and social life in a systematic manner. It clarifies the meaning of concepts such as freedom, equality, justice, democracy, secularism, and so on. Politics is referred to struggle for power, to maintain relationship between power and authority, which is a desire of an act of will. Further, political theory deals with how the present has come and on what assumptions it may stay, and in future what it will lead. India is a free country where issues concerning freedom, equality, and democracy arise from time to time and implemented also by the intervention of the state. As freedom has been guaranteed by the constitution, still many discriminatory issues are raised in and encountered with the interpretations of the state. Along with the change in time and periods, people's aspirations and needs are also changed, and new dimensions are discovered as well. Further, the philosophy of the constitution does not contain only moral content, but mediate between the various interpretations of the core value of Indian polity. The constitution of India has made the arrangements to protect the rights and interests of scheduled castes, scheduled tribes, minorities by providing the reservation of seats in the legislatures for them. The same reservations have been made for them even in government jobs, also to secure their interests. The Indian Constitution guarantees the right to primary education for all. This right remains formal. Further, the Constitution of India is a supreme law to be respected and accepted by the institutions and citizens both, because only this protects the fundamental liberties of citizens and country. The Constitution of India experiences the federal character because it distributes the powers between the central government and its constituent units. It's a written document. It is partially flexible and partially rigid. Political theory exposes us to systematic thinking on justice or equality so that we can polish our opinions and argue in an informed manner and for the sake of common interests. The Constitution has a centralized idea of national unity as its preamble outlines the objectives of Constitution by providing justice, equality, fraternity, liberty, and unity and integrity of the country. The philosophy of the constitution can be approached by getting the concept of constitutions in a clear manner, grasping or analyzing the set of ideals in the constitution as well as a detailed justification for the same. The philosophy of the constitution mainly emphasizes on peaceful and democratic transformations in the form of equality, freedom, and national unity and integrity. We study political theory. This is a question. So, political theory means problems without a solution. We are part of a particular society. We should understand that society from where we belong. Political theory makes it easy for us. People in every society carry ideas. From those ideas, we can understand our position in that society. Political theory helps us understand those concepts and helps us to realize our identity. We ask ourselves who we are. If we answer that we are the citizens of a particular country, then what do we mean by citizens? The idea of citizenship is shaped by political theory, and it has its universal acceptability. Just like this, our concepts of equality, freedom, rights, justice, etc., all are shaped by political theory. Political theory decides how we look at our society as a political man. Suppose we are a worker, and our question for us is, why are we deprived? To find the answer, we need to understand the class of society or the hierarchy of society, as Karl Marx has rightly said. Theory of class struggle helps us to understand the notion of class, and we will also get the answers that why we are so deprived of this hierarchical structure of the society. Political theory and political theory performs several functions that are very needful for our society as well as the world. So understand what is going on in the society and the world as well. Political theory helps to understand what is actually happening surrounding us and throughout the world as well. Political theory tells us how we can collect data from those political events and how to study it systematically. So with this, we have completed our lecture. We'll meet soon, we'll coming soon. If you want to contact with us, WhatsApp number is on screen. My email ID is visible on screen. So like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We'll meet in next lecture. Till then, bye, and Allah Hafiz. Thank you very much.